Nope.
Hello, mother. Wait a minute.
Came, I saw, I came, I saw, I praise the Lord and break.
Yo, man, we're back out here with some more Fortnite real quick. Now, Season 6 has just dropped. As you guys can see, we got a new background, new battle pass as well. Now, I think last time I bought, like, a lot of the tiers. I don't think I bought all of them, but quite a lot of them. But this time, I'm not feeling that. I only bought, like, the standard battle pass this time. So, I got these first two skins. I got the DJ Yonder, and I got the Calamity, which is pretty cool. This is, like, the Drifter this season, in the sense that you can upgrade this one. In fact, yo, quickly, let me show you guys all the skins. So, you've got the Giddy Up right here as well. You've got different weapons. You got... Bro, you guys know. You guys know how much I love that Ready Man song, man. I use it like a lot of the time, but I hate the fact that out there you just can't use a normal instrumental. It's kind of annoying because it doesn't have the same effect. Anyway, what other skins is the Fable? Okay, you got a little Red Riding Hood out here. Oh yeah, you can get pets now, so you can get like dogs in your little backpack, which is pretty cool. This skin right here as well, the Dusk. Okay, looking pretty crazy. I think, is that the final one before the? Oh no, you got the Tomato skin one, Nightshade. Okay, the Black Hood looks a bit mad. Not gonna lie to you. And finally, I'm pretty sure this is it. Yeah, the max tier one, the Dire. Now this upgrades to, I was thinking like, what the hell is it? And then it upgrades to the final werewolf, which is the, I think it's the black one, right? Yeah, there we go. You upgrade to the Black Werewolf. Crazy, man. It's crazy. I mean, I'm probably not even gonna get there. I'm not gonna lie. By the time like Blackout comes out, I'll probably be grinding that. But anyway, yeah, all this has changed. But one crazy thing that's been added into this game, specifically on console. In fact, you could probably do this on PC as well if you use your controller on a PC, is basically keybinds. Now, you guys know it was kind of annoying. If you wanted to plug your controller into your PC, it would be a little bit annoying because, for example, if you had like certain settings on console, you wouldn't be able to change the controller settings on PC. And even on console as well, you can't like change what you want like the certain button to do unless you go into the actual PS4 settings, but even there you kind of limit it. Whereas on PC, in fact, let me show you guys real quick. Whereas on PC, there you go, look, you just had like normal keybinds anyway, so you could legit switch like W to whatever you wanted to do, all that different stuff. You could attach each key to like whatever you wanted, so you could adjust it to you how you wanted it, but you could never do that with controller until now. But finally, they've added custom layouts for the controller, which is pretty cool. You guys can see, got old school right here, quick builder, combat pro, builder pro, which is what I typically use, but you've also got custom now. I've actually already made a custom one that I like to use. I'm gonna be showing you guys the best custom layout on console that you could possibly use, in my opinion. I know a lot of you guys will have different opinions, and you won't hesitate to let me know in the comments, that's for sure. Hey, I think I've got a pretty good layout right here. Now, usually what I would actually do, I don't know if I've mentioned this to you before, but usually I'd go into the settings, accessibility, button assignments. I know most of you guys are on PS4, but you can also do this on Xbox. But I'd go into like custom button assignments right here, like make my own assignment so I can change. My main thing that I would want to do, I did this on Call of Duty, which is why I wanted to transfer it over to PS4 as well. I want to change the shoot button, which is like the trigger usually, R2. I want to change that to the shoulder button and vice versa. So basically, I want to swap the triggers for the bumpers. Like basically, I'd be aiming with the bumpers and switching with the triggers. And the reason why I do that, and I know a lot of people do that as well, first of all, Call of Duty, it just made a lot more sense on Call of Duty just because the bumpers take like less time to actually push down. So say if you find like a, I don't know, I'm trying to think of something similar in this game. Maybe a pistol, for example, it takes a lot more time for you to press the bumper than the trigger all the way down. So realistically, you'll be able to shoot the weapon a lot quicker, which is why people use the bumpers instead of the triggers to shoot. You couldn't change that in the actual game. You had to do it on PS4, but now you've got a lot more accessibility and a lot more customization with the controller. And now I'm gonna show you guys my custom one, but obviously before we do get into this, definitely make sure you smash the like button on this video real quick. Like for real, let's see how many likes we can get, man. I know you guys will find this pretty useful. I definitely found it useful. I know a lot of people haven't actually been covering this. So you can drop a like. If you are new around here, of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We are trying to get to 100K pretty soon. We just hit 90K, which is crazy. I appreciate you guys for real. All right, let's do this, man. Let me show you guys this in a little bit more detail. Now, I'm actually going to reset, so I have to do it all again so you guys can follow all the steps. So first of all, you go into custom right here. You guys know where I am. I'm in the setting. Again, usually I'd use Builder Pro. If you're using anything other to build a pro. I don't know what's up with you. I really don't know what's up with you, man. But yo, we're gonna use custom right here. We're gonna go to custom. We're gonna go across. Now you can legit select anything you want. You can customize whatever you want right here. Now I'm not only gonna change the aim and different stuff, I'm gonna change one other thing, one other key thing which will help you out. I know you guys, you could probably do more stuff actually, so if you want to let me know something in the comments down below, then by all means do that, for real. But first of all, what I'm gonna change, like I said, I like to switch the triggers for the bumpers. So what I'm gonna do, previous weapon, which is L1, I'm gonna change that to aim down sights, and then this is now unbound, so you gotta change L2 to previous weapon now, which is, you're basically just swapping these two around. That's all you're doing. So now over here you do the exact same. So this one, R1, which is next weapon, you change that to attack. Yeah, you change that to attack, and now this one's unbound, so you change that one. Where's next weapon at? Yeah, there we go, next weapon. So that's basically what you do for this. That's what I've done. So now I'm shooting with the bumpers and switching weapons with the triggers, because I don't know, it just feels more, just makes more sense to me, you know what I'm saying, coming from college. And I know a lot of you guys do too. But the rest of the stuff, like inventory, up on a D-pad, all different stuff, I mean, you can change those if you want, but none of them are really that important to me, so I don't really do that. But when you go over to build controls, this is where it switches over a little bit. So again, what you're gonna have to do, you have to switch these ones. So L2 is gonna be cool. What I like to do now, every time, ever since I switched over to Builder Pro, one of my problems was placing down traps, and then hit square again. It was weird. It was just an awkward way to get to your traps and like switch through traps and stuff like that. And I don't know whether this was like a personal problem or whether you guys experienced this as well. It was the fact that when I'd get into build fights, man, randomly my stairs would rotate because I'm like pressing down the analog stick too much. The right analog stick would be mad annoying, puts you off completely. You got like stand there and like process how to switch it back, all different stuff. It ruins you completely. But what I do is, thinking about all those things, trap picker, which is square, all the way down to rotate. Now you don't actually have to bind this to anything, but this is what I do. I'ma switch the analog stick to that. But now we're gonna hop into a game, use this new setting right here. Let me know what you guys think of it in the comments down below. Trust me, if you use this with Builder Pro, you're unstoppable. It's crazy. These are the best key binds, button binds, whatever they're called. Yeah, so I hopped into some 50-50 just because, first of all, I've not really like properly played in a while, and obviously I'll get into some more engagements in here rather than just hopping in normal solos, because right now everyone's dying mad quick in solos because they're just going to like these crazy places, which I'm kind of going to right now. But you know, I'm trying to get into some more engagements, I'm trying to get some good weapons, I'm trying to kill some people, and that's more likely to happen in some 50-50 out here, man. So that's what we're about to do. Like, look at this, look how loot late has changed. It's crazy. Oh wait. Bro, my man, don't ever sneak up on me like that again. What do you think this is, fool? Hey, bro, that scared the life out of me because I thought I was just surrounded by teammates. I don't know what he thought he was doing. Oh. Here we go. What? Yeah, that's right. Oh. Hoo-hoo. Give me this. That's my, I was gonna say, I'm taking that kill. Bro, hello? Let's go, man, bro. You got a nice 10 kill. I will definitely take that. Alright, so yeah, I've switched a lot now. After that one game, I'm gonna show you guys real quick, I've switched a hell of a lot. So look at this now. So my switch mode, which takes you to like where you can build, is now the right analog stick, which I don't know, the reason for that is it's a lot quicker to get to. You know, you want to build as quick as possible, especially in this game with how essential building is. You need to be on point. When you get shot in the back, you need to build it as quick as possible, which is why I switched it to somewhere my thumb always is, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, my crouch button is circle, which is kind of annoying, and it's gonna take a little bit to get used to, but it's like, I don't know, it just makes sense in my head, you know what I'm saying? I'd rather be able to build quicker than crouch quicker, do you know what I'm saying? It just makes a lot more sense in my head, and that's why I've done that. Everything else is pretty much the same as the bro. Okay, at least I got everything. Yeah, everything else is pretty much, I believe, the same as like the other game. You guys don't have to worry about that. I just felt like this has to be done. And once I get used to this, best believe it's gonna be like the best setup for me ever, and you guys too. But I'm gonna change putting down the trap to this emote picker thing. Let me see. Here we go. Later. Okay, so this now should be a lot easier for me. I can place down traps just by pressing down on the D-pad.
Make these bitches fall in love. All of my niggas on go.